All right, everybody. We're back with the Share Chair video podcast. I actually don't know you guys if like I think that is an oxymoron, right? Like a podcast.
Yeah.
It's a vlog now, the Share Chair vlog.
Vlog channel.
And I'm here with co-host Maddie Ball. Hi, Maddie.
Hi.
And Skylar and Kyle Kuhn from their house. Welcome.
Hello.
One of the things I've really been enjoying is like, maybe I shouldn't admit that I'm enjoying this. I enjoy getting a peek inside of your homes.
Oh, right. You know? I understand that.
So like behind you, this map of the world is kind of nice.
Oh, yeah. It's just a cheap tapestry I got.
Yeah, are you like tracking COVID-19 cases on it?
I should. It's not a very accurate map though. It's got like dragons on it, I think.
Oh.
It's not very accurate. It's just for show.
Okay. Well, Aaron Burke had Beatles. Somebody else had another Beatles reference. So lots of Beatles designs in people's homes.
Yeah, I have my records over there, but you can't see those.
Nice. Cool. So, you know, the thing that's front and center on my mind, obviously, especially with three seniors here, is the disappointment of missing out on school things. Mm-hmm. School itself, but school things. Mm-hmm. And each of you are involved in the spring musical. Maybe. Oh, sorry. Actually, Maddie. That's right. And actually, I think like even in the fall, though you weren't in the play, I think you were like taking photos. Like you hang around the theater.
Yeah, I'm with them.
Yeah.
She's there.
So one of the things that's on my mind is, well, first of all, just saying like how far you were into the musical some way, right? Whereas sports hadn't really quite kicked off, maybe they had a week or something. I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, I think that the spring musical was a few weeks underway.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And even the, because this is like for this show, Music Man, by the way, for those that don't know, we're doing Music Man, and it's probably the most ambitious set we've ever decided to do. The set for it began even before rehearsals and auditions began. And then we had our winter trainings and stuff. So we started this as far back as, was it maybe December? Is that when we start winter trainings maybe? So yeah, this has been going on for a very long time. Our rehearsals started in start of February. So we were going for a little over a month, I'd say, when told us we were not allowed to go in. And on our very last rehearsal, we did a very, very rough run through of the shows. So we have almost all the pieces there, and we were getting so close. We were getting on such a rhythm. Then they're like, okay.
We have the outline of it. We blocked over half of the show and over half of the numbers. So we were very close to being to the point of just running it and perfecting it.
So
this actually starts, so those winter, so I know that you work on Saturdays for about 3 hours even before official rehearsals, when you start going about 6 days a week for 3 hours, but you were doing, I didn't realize, so these winter rehearsals or these winter what did you call them, winter
trainings.
They were going for that was all geared toward Music Man as well.
Yeah.
Audition.
That's for auditions. They teach us like the dances and the songs and some of the scenes that we'll be working on at auditions. So you're not just going in completely
for
blind.
Maybe like 2 months.
Yeah.
Before we even auditioned work.
So describe the set a little bit. You talked about the ambition of the set. What were some of the things, some of the big ideas?
Well, I have not been as involved as I should be with that effect. Everyone's required to get a certain amount of build hours, and I was kind of waiting off on that.
Well, it's two levels, like usable levels.
I don't even know that much.
Really? She posted the design. Wow. It's fine. And we have, we are building, I mean, we're not people to talk to about this. We have like a whole set designer and like set crew of like professionals.
Okay.
And we have, so I know for sure it's two levels and we were working on different flies to bring in and out. It is going to be very nice once.
Okay. So this we need, before we get there, because I definitely want to hear about like that, what's the future of this show? Because like I said, I feel like it's different than sports in the regard that sports is like a bigger state body that's like controlling it. And there's, but like one, you were underway for several months, really. Two, you're also organized just within the school. And so let's talk about that in a second, but could you actually tell me about that last rehearsal? What was the spirit or the mood?
I think, going into that last rehearsal, we didn't know the full details of whether it was our last rehearsal completely or last rehearsal for this time period. So I think I personally, as a senior, I walked in and I felt a little bit defeated. I was visibly upset at one point, not in like an angry, but like a sad way. And it was disappointing and upsetting being that it, at that point, it felt a little bit hopeless because we didn't know the future at all. But as Shay talked to us and as a cast, we all came together. And it was upsetting walking out of there, but we left like hopeful because we said we weren't done. It was just a break. So,
yeah, the main going into that rehearsal, at least we knew that was going to be because that was school got canceled. They said we're closing for 3 weeks on that Thursday. We were allowed to come to school the next Friday. And then we had a rehearsal on that Saturday. We were still allowed to come that weekend. And then they were like, okay, that's it. This is your last one.
Okay.
But we, at that time, were still planning on coming back to school after 3 weeks plus spring break. Yeah. So about a month. So that was the plan. That it was all just, it was changing so fast. Originally, when we heard school was closing, they told us you're still allowed to use the auditorium over this break. So we were like, sweet, we're gonna keep rehearsing. And then the next day they're like, yeah, no, you don't get to do that.
It's crazy, isn't it, how that idea, which was only just a month, only like 3 weeks ago, now feels like, what were we thinking? I mean, now that we know so much, it's just weird how with every passing day for me, it's like yesterday my thought seems archaic or like, crazy.
Yeah, but I went into that. It was definitely, we didn't feel, I don't know. I wouldn't say it seemed completely
hopeless,
but it seemed like, not that this is a fact I can relate to, but the, like, for seniors, their last week of school, not that I'll get that now. You're just like, why am I here? I don't, like, this doesn't have any effect. I would say it kind of felt like that. It was like, I don't really know what we're doing here. I don't think it'll help us out much, but it was still, we had the mindset that we were going to.
Yeah.
So there was lots of that motivation being talked on staying rigorous and adamant over that 4 week break to keep up to date on all your songs and dances and scenes and whatnot.
Okay. So where do we stand now? I mean, where are we currently? I know we're still waiting to hear from the governor, but it's not looking good that we'll go back. I mean, I've got fingers crossed, but we'll see. So where does the musical stand currently?
Well, this is very hot breaking news that I was told not to tell a lot of people.
Well, she sent the email out.
But she sent the email out, so I think it's
fine. We just couldn't tell them that she sent the email.
That's true. Okay. Now that the email's out, I think it's fine. And but as of now, with the expectation that we're not going back to school for the rest of this school year, is the plan to do Music Man in the summer now.
Okay, good.
Yeah, good. We don't know when it'll be. We don't have a date yet. It won't be right away. We still want a fair bit of rehearsal time.
Yeah.
And it's going to be very complicated. I saw something sent out today that because Shay already has three other shows going on in the summer, then tack on an entire high school show, that coordinating that much would be insane for her. And then I saw a thing today that apparently they're planning on rescheduling a bunch of senior stuff for over the summer, like our graduation and things like that. And I know one of the proposed weekends they put out is, because I do my own summer theater thing, one of those proposed weekends is the same one that I was planning on doing my show.
Okay. So it's going to be, it's going to be complex for sure.
Yeah. Coordinating all that, very little specifics on it, but right now, and we don't even know if we'll be allowed to like be in that large of groups again come summertime, but.
I know. So this, there's so much that's just holding off, but there's still a hope that the show will go on.
Yes. Yeah. The show is not canceled, but it is further postponed now.
Okay.
Announcing this thing that we're still going to.
Okay.
So you guys, you two are in, though, this really interesting spot where you're ending. It's like it's the spot you would have been in school, where you're ending one thing but starting another. Mm-hmm. I mean, you're sort of the only downside is you're not really ending with all the celebration that you would have had. So in some ways, I have to think your future is becoming even more. Like, I don't know, you're probably thinking, I would guess you're thinking about the future even more now because you have time, right? You're not busying yourself with rehearsals and stuff. And I know that you two have been doing the audition circuit like crazy. And I also know, and I want to be sensitive and aware of this, that there's been joy and frustration. So should we start with, I don't know, who wants to start? What is it about auditioning and hoping for an uncertain future that's like fills you with anxiety and fills you with hope?
Well, you want me to start?
Sure.
Take it, Skylar. Skylar, let's just rip the band-aid off. You've got great news.
I do. I was accepted to Tisch School of the Arts at New York University on Monday.
Amazing. That's so cool. Which is
great news. I'm not officially going yet. I still have to, it's very expensive. I have to figure out finances and stuff, but I'm very hopeful to attend.
Good.
So, I mean, that's good. That's the joy.
Yeah. Attend or not, it's amazing to have gotten in and to consider what that means then for your future. It's just really cool. You know, so you auditioned for that with like how many people, what did you have to do in that audition?
So we auditioned back in January, and there's a few different audition options. There's an online option. There's like, they have different cities where people will go, but Kyle and I ended up doing the route where we flew to New York and auditioned on campus. So what that looks like is you show up in New York, obviously, and you have a scheduled time. There were two time slots. There was a 9 a.m. and then a noon time slot. We would audition the same day, but I auditioned at 9. And how many people would you say were there?
Just in that audition slot, probably. I mean, well, for yours was much smaller. Mine was,
but just total.
Oh, total, like auditioners, probably like 50.
Like 50 okay. per group. So just one day, like 100 people audition.
Yeah.
And
you had to have, though, like Shakespeare ready or classical, modern?
Not for New York.
Okay.
University. It was advised against it. They wanted to see how you do with contemporary. And then, so you do your two contemporary monologues. For me, he had a different audition process because I went straight drama. He did musical theater. But so for me, I was separated into a smaller group of 10 people and I was given the number 3. So I was the third one to go. And so I would go in And then I did my two monologues, and then you would sit down for an interview portion. And in that interview portion is kind of when they figure out, they ask you like how much you know about Shakespeare, how comfortable you are with it. So that's where that comes in, because a lot of people aren't comfortable, so they don't want to force them to do something like okay. that would compromise their, I guess, like opportunity. But in the interview questions, they're different for everyone. But for me, he just asked what kind of books I read, what music I do, how I, not music I do, music I listen to, how I yeah. approach a monologue. And then he asked me like why I do what I do and
cool.
what else I've done. And it was just nice to talk about things I do other than theater too.
Yeah. Yeah. So. Good, good, good. And then, just recently you got the letter, right? Welcoming yeah. you to, yeah. How mm-hmm. did that feel?
It was so overwhelming. I mean, this particular school has been like my number one since middle school.
Mm-hmm.
I've always wanted to go here. So getting the good news, especially with a school that's so selective, first I was just so happy and excited, and I cried a lot, but mm-hmm. I was just very like overwhelmed.
Yeah. And Kyle gave a little like, yeah, yeah. a lot of tears.
And then the reality of like the cost and stuff.
Yeah.
Hit later, which wasn't like defeating, but it's a something to consider. So
very realistic like observation or something, right?
Well, I'm still very excited and like grateful that I have this opportunity. I'm just hoping that I can make it work.
Good, good, good. Now, Kyle, the truth of an artist's life is that it is not linear, that it is never, it doesn't just go from A to B, and it's often circuitous, and it often takes all kinds of loops. And so I know that for you, that it's been harder, right? The audition process, and it just hasn't, like, you haven't gotten that email of saying you're in, and you have the tears and the, And how's that feeling? Are you hanging in there with it? What's up?
Not only not getting the yes emails, I've just been getting all no emails, actually.
Yeah.
So I auditioned for 4 schools.
Mm-hmm.
And it was, I don't know, there's some people I hear that are out there auditioning for like 30, which for how insanely selective every single theater program is, that seems like maybe it would have been a better idea, because I got the first one back, U of M. They had 4,000 applicants this year, and they accept 24 people. They said no. That was my number one, and I was like, okay, well, I mean, can't mm-hmm. win. That's like one of the best theater programs. Wasn't expecting that. And I got an email from Western University of Western Michigan University. Yeah. They were my next choice. They have an insane theater program.
Yeah.
They had, I think they said somewhere like above 500 applicants, somewhere in there, they said like that. And they accept 15 people.
Yeah.
Even less. What they said to me is for Western, I'm on the wait list, which isn't as bad.
Very
and
high.
They emailed me personally because I didn't see their first email. And they said, I'm very high on the wait list, meaning out of like the couple hundred people that audition, I'm somewhere in like the top like 20-ish, maybe.
And who knows? And these types of things, I'm telling you, there is no, I mean, having been in that world a bit, there is no direct line. I mean, even in the best possible line, which is like, you know, maybe NYU, right? There's no guarantee. I mean, you could find any number of NYU students who then did not, you know, make a career in the arts. Of course, a lot do, but it's not, you know. So there's also, Kyle, this and Skylar too. You have run into this and will continue to, where you just are going to hear, no, 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 no.
Yeah.
And then do you have the fortitude to keep pressing until you get the yes? Because of course it only takes one certain yes to launch, to launch things. So yeah, listen, I know the joys and challenges that you're both feeling. I've had the elation and have had so much no. And after you hear yes a lot, that it kind of stings for a bit, but you need to rely on the fact that you're good enough to keep working for that yes. Mm-hmm. So and just I wanted to ask this too before we move on, but is the you two in high school are known for your creativity, your spirit, your joy, your hard work. But primarily I'd say, I mean, Maddie, would you agree that creativity is key? Yeah. The Coons are known for their creativity. Yeah. And, how has that helped you? Has it helped you? And if so, how during the stay at home, stay safe time?
Go ahead.
Well, I don't know. I would say right now, more days often than not, it becomes pretty much the same thing of me like playing Animal Crossing and just like sleeping and eating food. But I feel like the days where I do actually say, okay, I'm going to do something today, then it definitely takes, I still am finding ways to stay motivated and whatnot. And what you said specifically about being creative, when you're doing something creative, it gives you like complete personal control over it. And in this world where we have nothing we can control right now. So it feels very nice to like do something and say like, look, I did this. Like I, you know, did a concert on my Instagram, of course. That was kind of fun. It went on for far longer than it should have, but I was just talking to people and getting a little taste of the outside world again. So that was nice. And then, I haven't even told Skyler this yet. I started working on a little short mini movie sort of thing I'm going to be making in our quarantine. And that one's really fun because I'm giving myself like obviously complete 100% creative control over it. I'm like writing music for it and like going to be doing all the cinematography and stuff. So that's something that like gets me excited and I look forward to, and I don't know, it's something to wake up in the morning or, you know, the day before, be like, okay, here's what I'm going to do tomorrow. I have a plan. I'll actually like wake up at a reasonable time, maybe, you know, it's some sort of schedule. And I feel like doing that in these times makes your life feel a little more sane. Than
for sure. For sure.
Same thing every day where all the days blur together.
Do we get
you know, Skylar? Skylar, I'm curious too, like there are a lot of people, of course, who don't have this foundation of creativity, right? Mm-hmm. I'm guessing, you know, it must be a struggle to figure out what to do and how to kind of create something or make something or important with the day. How are you finding? I mean, has creativity helped you out in this rough time?
Well, I think in the creativity aspect of like creating like movies and stuff, that's his deal. That's his thing. But for me, what I've been doing with my, I guess my creative outlet has also been kind of an academic one, but I've been applying to lots of scholarships with this new opportunity that I have. So I find, and not all of them are just essay scholarships, like just what do you want to do? Like yesterday I had to write a short story about a leprechaun for a scholarship.
Okay, great. Creativity, right?
Yeah, and then there's other ones where it's like make a like a mini movie of you like doing something you enjoy. And it's so I think for me, I've been taking my creativity and trying to put it into something that will also help me academically. But then I've also been like playing music and so.
Yeah, good, good. Hey, Coons, you know, I really, well, I miss being in school with your energy, and I miss seeing you day to day. Let's wrap up with the Share Chair's famous last question. Maddie, you want to take it over?
Yeah.
Kyle and Skylar, if you each had one piece of advice to give to anyone, what would it be?
I already gave my advice last time I was on here.
Is it the same though? Would you say?
I don't know. I got to come up with a second piece of advice.
Do you want me to go first?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. I guess what I would say, what I have been feeling recently, is that no dream is too ambitious if you're willing to work at it, even if it's like, no, there's other routes to it. So I would just say, keep working, even in these times. Don't just let everything go because we're stuck at home. So.
Yeah. Yeah. Kyle, anything?
Yeah. I thought of a new updated piece of advice. Wash your hands. Oh. That's it.
Good one.
You know what? That's good.
Stay washing, baby.
It's the BAFTA.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. CDC approved.
I see. Happy birthday twice. Happy birthday. Don't forget the thumbs. All right, y'all. Man, it's lovely to see everybody. And, spring break is right around the corner. So here's to having a good spring break in the house. And
break time. I deserve it.
And then also, though, fingers crossed that the spring musical is still going to happen at a later date. Okay?
Yeah.
All right. See everybody. Thanks so much.
Bye. So long.